I want you to think back to the worst flu you ever had. Now imagine that you still have that flu today, and every day in between has been a fever dream made up of fruitless doctor visits and symptoms that always get worse when you try to be active. You feel invisible to the world because you're stuck in bed, and it's not just unrefreshing sleep, but your thinking feels foggy, you have stomach problems, and on the worst days, even bright lights, sounds, or just standing up makes it physically painful to be around your loved ones and do the things you used to enjoy. There's no cure or approved treatment, and your friends, and even some of your doctors, think you're faking it. This is what millions of people worldwide suffering from myalgic encephalomyelitis, chronic fatigue syndrome, go through, sometimes for decades with no relief. Many say it all started with a viral-like illness, and it just never went away. And recently, some people with COVID-19 have experienced long-haul symptoms extending for months, similar to the never-ending symptoms seen on the slide, endured by ME/CFS patients, suggesting these COVID survivors are experiencing an overlap of symptoms and may have acquired some related type of disease. There are still so many unknowns, but the infectious nature of ME/CFS has led our group to study the immune response. What do I mean by immune response? Well, normally your immune cells are in a resting state, surveilling the body for things that look like they don't belong, like what these light blue and pink cells are doing on the left. When these cells encounter an enemy, like those yellow dots, they go through a series of changes to become an army that signals for backup and puts out an attack. This is the immune response. Part of the reason they're able to become this army is because they start fueling up on different types of energy-filled molecules, putting these cells into attack mode. This is the immune cell's metabolism, all happening in or near that brown mitochondria seen in the middle. This powerhouse of the cell is involved in deciding which of these molecules, seen to the right of the mitochondria, gets metabolized, energizing these cells to make those important changes. Think of it like changing your diet to train for a marathon, loading up on protein shakes, or cutting out fats to help you succeed. But in this case, things like fatty acids and glucose are being rebalanced, and your immune cells are fueling up for a different kind of marathon, the defense of the human body. If for any reason these fuels are unable to shift and prioritize, well, your immune response will fall short. And this is what I investigate. Starting with blood from both patients and healthy controls, I isolate immune cells to compare how their metabolism shifts during a simulated infection, using techniques that look for cell markers. These act as little flags on the cell that say things like, hey, I'm using a lot of glucose. What I found is that ME/CFS immune cells are more reliant on fuels that are just not suitable for a robust immune response, as noted on the clipboard. Armed with this metabolic profile, we can start thinking about treatment options, such as injecting molecules to block those less than ideal pathways, properly balancing these fuels for immune cells. Rebalancing the immune system may be a big step towards finally providing relief towards these individuals, perhaps allowing them to go back to their lives and be visible to the world once again. Thank you.